1606, it was Captain John Smith who sailed by and gave it a name. In 1686, it was Crockett and Sons who were first to make a land claim. In 1814, the British fleet sailed from the island to the Chesapeake Bay to attack Fort McHenry and inspire a song that we all sing today. And now the water is rising in spite of all we can do. And Tangier Island is slipping away, and soon other islands will too. Oh, Tangier is home to 500, mostly watermen who work on the bay. Faith is still strong there and the island is dry, so some always find a way. There's a boat that leaves for the mainland with oysters and crabs to be sold, and the homesteaders laugh when the tourists all leave as soon as the weather turns cold. And now the waters are rising in spite of all we can do. And Tangier Island is slipping away, soon other islands will too. Once there were 2,000 acres with plenty of room to grow, and now there are only 800, and in 50 more years or so, Tangier will be all underwater, with all of its residents flown back to a shrinking mainland with little they used to own. And now the water is rising in spite of all we can do. Tangier Island is slipping away, soon other islands will too. We've all heard of far-off islands like the Maldives or Tiribati shore, where soon rising waters will cover land and turn it to ocean floor. It's been too easy to forget and move on, those islands seem so far away. But Tangier Island is in old Virginia, and we could be there today. And now the waters are rising in spite of all we can do. And Tangier Island is slipping away, it's another